Hi everyone, my name is Aiva Furfaro and I'm 10 years old. Today I will be talking to you about the importance of saving the planet through no pollution. Pollution affects my life every day, but I'm only 10. So to get better informed about this topic, I contacted some experts at the Jane Goodall Institute and I was so excited when they emailed me back. The first question that I asked was if I was too young to become an activist. Mary Ford and Lauren Seville from the Jane Goodall Institute Roots and Shoots Youth Program both agreed that I was at the perfect age to start helping to save our planet. Lauren Seville said no one is too young to become an activist. Anyone can educate and motivate others to make a change in their local community. Mary Ford replied that no one is too young to try and get people to stop polluting. She even encouraged me to sign up for the Roots and Shoots program, and I did. Did you know that there are many types of pollution? The types of pollution that I would like to find solutions to are air pollution, littering, and water pollution. These are the top three most dangerous pollutions that we're facing today, and I often hear about this in the news, at school, and from my parents. Lauren Seville was kind enough to share what her thoughts on this topic are. For example, she told me that she believed that the biggest problem today is the amount of garbage that we produce as a society. The amount of single-use plastic that we use is surprising, and they break down into microplastics, which can get into our soils and food. And each time you throw plastic or trash on the ground, this contributes to the forest fires that we see happening around the world today. And we all know how badly those forest fires affect our air quality. Which brings me to the first type of pollution, air pollution. Forest fires, as we know, are a major concern right now. The poor air quality is not only affecting our health, but causing a major climate change too. Factories are also another issue. Because they let out smoke every single day, we are inhaling it, and this is bad for our body and for our earth. The reason I know that this is bad is because next to my house there's a factory that lets out a lot of smoke and bad odors, and for years my community has been fighting to stop them, and we will not stop until we win. Littering is also another type of pollution that really makes me sad. It is causing a lot of damage to our forests, green spaces, bodies of water, and our animals. I asked my parents about this and they were the ones who informed me about how people's garbage is really affecting our planet in a negative way. I also watched videos on YouTube and checked out the Roots and Shoots website. And check out the Earth Rangers app too. This really helped me learn a lot about how to become an Earth Ranger at a very young age. Finally, I like to find a strategy to water pollution. Water pollution is really hurting and killing our animals, as well as making our bodies of water dirtier. And if we don't fix this problem, by the year 2050, the oceans will have more plastic than fish. And that's scary to think about. Last year, I presented a project for school, and my topic was about pollution and recycling. I researched a lot of this information online and found this really cool video on YouTube called Angry Earth Waste. So feel free to check out the Angry Earth series. You will learn a lot too. And because I shared it with my classmates, now they are all more aware about this issue. And I know that it's hard to believe all the facts that we see and hear. But after speaking to the experts that I mentioned earlier, I was happy to read that they even answered my question about what we could do as the youth to help save our planet. For example, Lauren Seville said that we need to consume less plastic by using more reusable products. And grown-ups, stop buying single plastic coffee cups. Bring your own mug. And guess what? Your coffee will stay hot too. Lastly, she mentioned that composting is a wonderful way to reduce food waste. You can start small, like creating a compost bin in your backyard or at school as a community project. There's so much we could do with leftover food. Now let's discuss the main reason for my talk. Recycling. Recycling is one of the many strategies to help keep our planet a better place. I learned this from my mom and dad at a very young age, as well as at school and in my community. The first time this topic truly bothered me was when I was 3 years old. I was sitting at McDonald's and I was looking out of the window. I noticed so much trash on the ground that I immediately started crying. I asked my mom why people would make such a mess. And that's when she told me about recycling and the importance of doing it every single day. Instead of throwing away all recyclable items, we should be reusing them. If not, be sure to place them inside of your recycling bin instead of throwing them away in the trash or on the streets. The next time you go on vacation, make sure to bring a reusable bottle instead of buying plastic bottles. This will help encourage you not to pollute or throw single-use plastic in the ocean or on the ground. You can also buy reusable Ziploc bags. This will help eliminate plastic waste, and all you need to do is use, wash, and reuse. Now for the fun part. How can we, the youth, make not polluting fun? And by we, I mean friends, family, and your supportive community. I think Games. It's all about making something important fun and having a good time too. Here's some fun ways to help keep the environment clean and safe. 1. Start a green club at school where you can talk about strategies to help the environment around your school, clean trash, more stuff like that. 2. Dedicating 1 or 2 days of the week to only use reusable items. I did this in the first grade where every Wednesday we were encouraged to only bring reusable items in our lunchboxes. 3. Create eco-friendly art by reusing recyclable items. Hey teachers, this one's for you. Have your students bring in any recyclable items that they can use as art projects in the class. 4. Ride your bicycle and, if possible, get an electric car when you're old enough to drive. And 5. Start a pickup trash challenge. This is a fun way to get everyone involved. And yes, there are many more fun ideas, but if we do not take care of our planet properly, in the future, we will have a hard time gaining access to so many things we need, such as food and clothes. Also keep in mind that if we don't take care of the planet properly, we will no longer have access to clean pools, parks, as well as our many beautiful oceans. And all the beautiful greenery that we have now will no longer be green, but dirty and filled with lots of garbage, and sadly, dead animals too. So let's remember, there is no planet B. I want to share something that my grandfather once told my dad when he asked him about pollution. Unfortunately, my grandfather's generation was taught that pollution would be somebody else's problem one day. But guess what? He was right, because today it's become our problem, and a very big one too. But I have some advice, and that it's never too late to start recycling the proper way. You can even start today. I want to end this talk with something that really stood out in the email replies I got from the experts. Mary Ford said that she truly believed that Jane Goodall would agree that no one is too young to get involved, and that the power of the youth is one of Jane Goodall's greatest reasons for hope. And like the many women who have changed the world for the better, Jane Goodall was the inspiration behind my TED talk. As one of my many role models, this is a quote that will always inspire me to do good every day. You cannot get through a single day without having an impact on the world around you. What you do makes a difference, and you have to decide what kind of difference you want to make. Now let me ask you this, how will you make a difference? How will you decide what kind of difference you want to make, and how will you save your planet without hurting it?